going to compute the value of an option maybe after 2 months, because we know that when we talk about derivatives, we are talking about future market. So the present value concept comes into play whenever we are talking about future value. So in binomial pricing model, that's the crux, that's the concept where you are trying to arrive at the present value of the money, present value of an option, maybe with respect to strike price, what you're getting after maybe 1 month or 2 months or 3 months in the present period, when you are going to invest your money. You're just making a comparison between the spot and the future value. Future value in the present. So that is present value of the gain or the amount which you get from your option by investing in your option. You are comparing it whether to enter the spot market or it is better to go with the future market. So you are making a comparison to make the decision. So that's it. That's a basic concept of binomial option pricing. It's a model. Okay. So we are slowly entering into that. So as I said, pricing of a stock option by constructing a binomial tree. And I'll show you what is a binomial tree. There are many steps involved in that. So basically, it is constructing a binomial tree with different, as we say, a tree is having different branches. Likewise, a binomial model, binomial tree also would be having different branches, different nodes, depending upon the movement in the price of the option, what we expect, as we expect in future. And we also, in that tree, we show the possible paths. Different paths. No, suppose if it is just one up and down, just that. But if you have number of ups and downs, that happens, right? In the real market, that happens. So all that can be shown through a diagrammatic representation called binomial tree. And this model was proposed by Cox, Rocks and Robinson in the year way back in 1979. But it has undergone many changes over the period, like modifications based on market conditions. But as normal for every financial theory, here also, in this case also, we go with certain assumptions to make the situation a little simple. But maybe you may not feel a realistic one when we look into the real market conditions as it happened in Markowitz theory or any other theory as we learn in financial market. But the intention here is to make things simple for us to understand. So the basic assumption in this theory is stock price movements are binomial, two movement, ups and down, up and down. That is it, what we say binomial. So that is one assumption which is made in this particular theory, this concept. But it can be assumed in such a way that you are ignoring the minor corrections. You are just considering the major up and down. That can be that way we can look at it. Then no market frictions, in the sense there are no transaction costs, no entry fee, no exit fee, which is not practically right, but for the time being, we assume it to be like that. And competitive market, where everyone has equal chance of making profit. The market goes with the forces of demand and supply, which in real condition, we know many times, in almost most of the situations, that is not happening in a inefficient market. Since India, a country like, even in the developed markets, you cannot go with a condition where everything goes according to the demand and supply and based on everybody is informed about whatever happening in the market. That's not possible even today. So that again is a basic assumption to make it simple. Then indifferent towards risk, in the sense people they are not looking at the intensity of risk with different options. That is again, because in that case, if you consider that risk is a factor, risk appetite of the investor is taken into consideration, then the model becomes very complicated. So in order to avoid that, it has been said that people are indifferent towards risk, the appetite, risk appetite, or the risk bearing capacity of the investor is not taken into consideration. So these are the basic assumptions which one would be making when we go with binomial model for computation of option price. Okay, so these are the basic things. Now, time, basically, there are two types of binomial trees. One is single period, one step, one up and down. That's what we call as binomial model. And multi-period, two or three steps, like, you know, two or three laps based on number of days, or it can be even a single day divided into different time period, or it can be months. Normally that goes with months or days, because in option we don't talk about years. Maximum period we can know, as it is available in the stock market, maybe 3 months. Commodity may be a little different, but stock options, 3, 1, or 2 months. That's something which is generally available in the stock market. So multi-period would be days or months, right? Now I'm going to show you. See, this is actually a single period model. Single period model, here you can say this is the spot price. Maybe after one day you have one up and one down. This is what you expect. And then you look at what is the probability of getting this, and then this, and then you go with computation of this value. Okay. And once you get the value of this, you try to move backward. And then you come to the present value, the present period. Now in the spot market, the same asset is costing 50. And what is it? The present value of the amount which you are supposed to receive in future. That's what you come to. That's a basic concept of binomial model. So if I can get an asset, maybe the underlying asset is stock, and 50 rupees by entering into the spot market, I expect to make something different in a derivative market. Maybe I have to have at least the time value of money. I'm waiting for some time, maybe 1 month or 3 months. So it should be above the spot price. Otherwise, I should have gone to the spot market. I'm ready to wait some time because I expect much better in future. That's the general underlying principle that is guiding the derivative market. So in that case, I should evaluate whether the strike price. Here we just look into the European option, where there is only one exit period. You cannot exit at any time before the maturity. But in case of American model, the binomial computation becomes a little more complicated, because you have every point. Now, wherever you want, you can exit the market in case of American option. But in case of, as you say, no, a European option, you have an expiry date, expiration date, and in that date you have to get out of the market. So that is what we consider when we are discussing about a primary binomial model presently in our class. So here what we imagine here is maybe this period, this T, this is called as delta T. Delta T is the number of days that is included, or number of months. So imagine if this is after 1 month, after 1 day. This can happen in that way also. Suppose today it is 50, tomorrow the strike price for this is 55 and 35. There are possibility that it can go up. If it went up, it is 55. If it went down, this is 35. So this is the concept where option buyer will be going with the call option. And here, this, you know, a person who is expecting this to be the highest probability, then he would be going with this option, where which is called as put option. He is bearish, he is going to sell it. The other person, he is bullish, he is going to buy it from the market. So it depends on the strike price that is available in the market. So what we are trying to understand is, when I stand here, okay, I know that after 1 day, or maybe after 1 month, I can sell this at 55. So what is it now? I have a waiting time, right? Maybe if I have 1 month time, am I justifiable, or is my gain justifiable enough when I compare it with the spot market? That is what I do through binomial model. That's a basic idea behind binomial model. So that is why we reach there, and then we work backwards. We move backwards to understand the present value. We compute the future value, right? We compute based on the return expectation, like ups and downs and probability. and then we try to move step by step, right? So for example, this is an example of single period model. Now you can look, this is actually something which we most probably we will be getting to solve in our example. Here I have given the values, but this we really have to compute. And then reaching here, we have to travel back. We have to reach here, and then we have to make a comparison at the zero period, right? When I know that I have 144 here, I work backward. When I work backward, there are two probabilities. It can go up or go down. Likewise, I have two steps in this. This is actually two steps. The first up and down, the second up and down, the second up and down from here. First up and down from the up, and this is a possibility to move up. I'm sorry, possibility to move up and down. And it can happen in this spot. This may be 1 month. This may be 2 months. So I have to look at when I'm making an investment here, and when I'm promised 120 here, 80 here, what is the value? Does this justify, or does this earning justify the waiting time? That is something which we go with computation with respect to option. This is a basic concept. So binomial tree can be single period model where I'm just recording immediately. Maybe it is after 1 or 2 days. So I just record the first two prominent ups and downs. And this might be in 2 months or 3 months, I can have n number of. You can include that because here we have softwares. When we looking from an industrial point, binomial tree as such, they can do it by through softwares. It's available. And they might be doing using those software. So it's not as complicated as we manually do. But this is the concept. Okay. And when we are given with a manual example, we may not be given with like 10 to 15 labs and all. We might be having only like 2 or 3 nodal points. Nodes, as we call, each of this point is called as nodes. It will be given to us. So that's what we call as multi-period binomial tree. So as an introduction, binomial tree is actually a concept. It's a method through which we compute the option value, the present value of an earning which you are supposed to get on a future date, considering since it is in a real-time market, the probability factor will come, because these are based on our intuition. These are based on our calculated past, maybe our past experience, maybe past records, we've calculated it, or it can be also intuition based activities, or maybe the depending on the demand and supply. So it is available. So before making an investment, we should ensure that yes, we are going to get return by taking up this risk of investing in the derivative market. So this is one method which we would be learning in connection with computation of option pricing. Now we are going to look into the detailed steps that will be involved for computation here. Listen to me very carefully. How we have planned here is today we will learn the whole thing, and tomorrow we will solve it using an example. That's how we have planned it, because together it may not happen. You should be given little time to understand this. So the first step, as I said, the first step would be the tree generation, because in our exercise, they would be given that the possibility of ups and down with probability. Maybe they expect a 10% increase in the share price and that is reflected as a strike price. So they would be given the final node, or maybe they will give an indication of what is the percentage increase from the spot price when you look into the strike price. So the possibilities, the ups and downs will be given along with the probability figure would be given, or else we will go definitely the volatility would be given, because that's not something which we can assume. So the volatility or the standard deviation, the volatility is given as the measure in standard deviation. In this binomial tree, they will be given as what is the expected standard deviation, likewise, which indicates that this is the volatility, the change in the share price according to the market condition. So that's the first step. So the first step is the tree generation. a binomial tree of prices is produced from the valuation date to the expiration date by assigning stock prices. In our question, in our given exercise itself, they will indicate what is the value to be increased in different time periods. Each point where two lines meet is called as a node. Here, this is a node, this is a node. So that's what we call as nodes. And then at each step price of the underlying stock, here you will have an up and down. See, from here you can expect one, it can be 120 or it can even go down to 80. So if this is the case, if you have gone with the call price, right? In that case, what we have to understand is we have gone with, if this is the strike price, if the market went up, we are going to exercise this. But if the market went down, we are not going to exercise this. Right. So that's a concept which we have learned all through these classes. Same is applicable here also. So each step, price of underlying stock will move up and down. Up or down. Yeah. It can move up or, that's why we said the movements are assumed to be binomial. Then the up, now we are going with the computation part. The up, which is denominated as U, and the down, which is denominated as D, can be calculated based on the same concept which we have learned and ELOC. So U is equal to E raised to, this is standard deviation, volatility, which will be given in our question. The whole root of delta T, where delta T is nothing but the length of one step of a binomial tree. Say, for example, in the previous, if this takes no 1 day, that is it. If this take 1 month, then that will be that. So it will be 1 month. If that is the case, it will be 1/12. And likewise, so that's how we go with that T, delta T. Okay, length from one node to another. And when D is, as you said, negative, the down, no? So negative of standard deviation whole root of delta T. Now what we have to understand is, if when it comes as negative, it would be 1/e raised to standard deviation of whole root of delta T, which is nothing but 1/u, because we already compute U value. So it will be pretty easy for us to go with 1/u. For the value of D. Okay, so this is the first step. First step would be, we are, as I did know, I had constructed this and shown you, but in the exercise, the first part would be, we are constructing a tree like this. We have to have a tree like this. We have to draw it. We have to mark the prices, and then we go with computation of value. So if you know that there are two nodes, definitely we have to go with that. If there are three nodes, we have to go with that, depending on how it is given in our exercise, in the example given to us. And later we will compute the value for every U and every G. See, in this case, there is one U here and one D here. Again, here also, when you look, there is one U here, one D here. Here also one U and one D. If this is two steps. So you have, as you say, for every node, you will have one up and down. So we have to go with computation. So that is the first step. Okay, this is the first step in binomial tree computation. And once we get that, okay, once we get that, the step second process would be calculation of option value at each final node, option value, because this is just the what you get the actual price. The second is assigning the stock price, which is based on the question. Question as it is given, we just assign, okay, the value of tree, the price to be like this. The value of particular up and down can keep the stock value to be like this. Likewise, we are assigning the stock and the value of the underlying asset. Okay. Then we are going with computation of the option value at each final node. And that I said, in this example, I'm showing you only with respect to European option. And in case of European option, we know that the exit period will be the expiration date, the final date. There is no exit in between. That's actually the basic nature of European option. and we are just looking at how do we compute the option value at as you say, for in case of call option and in case of put option. That is the second step. Maybe we are given with it is binomial, so definitely you can understand that there can be situation where we go with buy option, a put option or call option. So maybe in a question you will be given with only one condition like call option. Sometimes you are also given with put option. In that case, you have to look from a different concept, remains same, but we know that the evaluation will become different because of the risk nature. Because in put option, we expect the price to be going down, and to protect from the fall in price, we go with put option. But in call option, things are different. Accordingly, in the formula also, you will find that difference. So the formula is max into Sn minus k, the whole into zero. That is, whichever is higher, that's a concept here. So k, as you say, k is the strike price, strike price divided by exercise price, and Sn, the spot price of the underlying asset at the nth period. The spot price, what is it the underlying asset will be having at here in this case at the end period, if it is American option, at maturity here in case of European option. And if you have more than one note, then nth period becomes, see for example here in this case, this is nth period and this is maturity. So that's the difference here. In if this is a European option, this is maturity, this is what they have said too. And this is nth period after maybe 1 month. But if you're talking about American option, anywhere it can be nth period for you, depending on where you exit. You do not have an expiration date, or you do not have the responsibility to wait till the expiration. You can exit at any time. So this nth period is more important in case of an American option. But time being, we are going with European option. So if that is why the formula difference, no, in case of Sn, spot price minus k. Why? Because k is strike price by exercise price, whereas in case of put option, it becomes k minus spot price, because you imagine that there is fall in the spot price, that is why you went with a strike price. So the strike price should be greater than your spot price, whereas in case of call, your spot price would be greater than your strike price. So that's a concept which we have learned. Accordingly, the formula is also set like that. It will be clear once you really do it. And then as you go with the computation, the final result of this will be, we will get value for each nodes. Okay, so each node we will have a value, either zero, or if it is greater than zero, we will surely show that. And in case of call option, definitely what we have to look from the perspective that the lesser option will have a value of zero, because in call we don't go with exercising it if your spot price is lesser than the strike price, because we can really get that as purchase that asset from the market at a lesser cost. So it is like that. Then we will understand. And then the third step is the actual computation of present value. So that is where we go with. I'll just tell you, we compute the value for each of these based on the probability, the underlying value, and then we try looking at from the perspective of our investment. That is, what is the present value of an earning which you are going to get in future? That is what you are going to do. What is the present value of maybe this in when you are standing here? Okay, so this is actually the strike price, I mean the spot price of this asset during that time based on the probability. But you compute the value for option here, and then you're converting each node into this. You convert this to here and this to finally here, to understand what is the kind of return which we can get when we invest, if we are planning to invest at the current spot price in a derivative market. Okay, when the spot price is 100. Okay, so that is something which we are going as our third step. third step where we go with computation of option value, each preceding the former one. We are working backwards. The option value at preceding nodes are calculated from the option value of the final node. That's only the way we are. We first look at what is the earning which you are going to get, then we are computing the present value. R, the concept of R remains same, rate of return, opportunity cost, the expected return, all that, the R remains same. So that is why this can ask for theory also. That's why that part is called as backward induction. Backward induction is nothing but you compute the actual value option and then you are traveling back to understand what is the present value of that earning which you are getting in future. Now you might understand why we had revised the concept of compounding and present value at the beginning of our syllabus. The concept is option is something which you are going to get in future. So when you are taking up an investment decision, we should know what is the present value of a future earning. That's what we are going to do here also. So that process is called as backward induction. Now, this is the probability factor. As I said, no, probability factor of up, if it is P, then there is only, it is whole is one, right? So if the probability of up is P, then the probability of down is 1 minus P. So that's why we say that the highest probability is expected with an increase in the price. So if you say that the probability is 60%, then 40% would be, yeah, there is a possibility that it can go down. Like as we say in risk, no, 99% I'm sure that I'm going to get a return of this much. So 1% is there, which is not there. So that will be probability of not getting that. The same concept here, 1 minus P. Now we go with expected option value I have not included one aspect, the computation of probability value, which I'll be adding when we are going with the exercise. There is a formula for computation of probability also. I will add that when we go with computation part in the next class. Okay, so expected option value is nothing but option up value into probability, because we have computed that value. We had gone with computation of, that was our step two. We went with computation of the value and then we are going with final option value. Okay, option up value into probability plus option down value into probability. That is 1 minus. In that case, probability for that would be 1 minus P. If possibility of going up is P, coming down is 1 minus P. That's what we have done this. And the last final step is calculation of, we have gone with calculation of option value at preceding node. Finally, we reach to, as I said, no, we will go with computation of this. When I take, I have this and this, right? So likewise, I have to compute for this. And then now in the first exercise, which we are doing, it's a call option. So this part is zero, because then you will understand how do we get this, because it's a call option. When the price go down, exercising is not happening. That is why this part is zero. So it will be easy for us in case of call option. And we finally reach here. Okay, we reach here, the final node, we complete here, we reach here, the final node. This is N4, N5, N6, okay, N1, N2. No, N2, N3, or we can look from this N2, N3, N4, N5, N6. We have to go with. So first we will go with computation for N4, N5, N6. Okay, you might find it a little difficult now, but after getting familiar with the theory, once we do that, it will be easy for you. So first we will go with N4, N5, N6. We get the value of that. Then we arrive at N3 and or if we can put this as N2 and N1, and then we go N2 and N3 and then N1. If I shift this to N3, there is no issue. But for you to have some sequencing, I said like that, because it's a call option, what do you expect would be this? From here, you expect this. That's why I made this is N2 and N3. And then 4, 5, 6 as your expectations. But if you put in the other way also, there is no problem. But only thing is that you should not go wrong by computing. That's all. So we go with the final stage of computation of the option value at the final node. That's what we did here. And then we are computing the present value of the option value. Final, no, preceding final node. So it's just the opposite of proceeding final node. Preceding final node, you are coming to the inner part just before the spot. That's why. So you go with the expected option value, because expected, why? It's our expectation. Nobody knows whether that is going to happen or not. It's something in future. Expected option value into the present value concept, the same as now e raised to negative r into t preceding. So e raised to minus r into t, where r is rate, t is the length, the time period involved in that. So expected option value. So first we go with the steps involved is like this. First we go with binomial tree construction. That's just arranging that. If we have just two nodes, it's very easy. In the sense, one up and down, that's good. If we have, as you said, no, 6 nodes, yes, we have to go with little more. No, careful with how do we go with. So we arrange that in the form of a binomial tree. Sometimes you might get the problem of just construction of a binomial tree. Maybe you don't go with computation of option value. But if it is like for 15 marks and all, you will go with computation of the, sometimes it can come for 15 marks. It had come in the previous years also. So if that is the case, then we will be going with computation, expected option value, the final. No, present value of the option, which value which you're going to have in maybe after 1 month or 2 months. So in that case, first we will compute the tree, then we'll compute the value in nodes, the value of the underlying asset, and then we go with computation of option price or option value, and then we start our journey backwards. Journey backwards in the sense we are going with the, we have the future value, we want the present value. That's how we go with backward induction. That's what we call as backward induction. And then we go with the final computation. Once you hear it for the first time, it might appear to be a lengthy process, but actually it is very simple. Just 2 or 3 steps. No, you just have to remember 2 or 3 formula. That's all. Here also, as we say, no, the Andy logarithm value needs to be taken up with E constant, as we learned for the previous in option, no, in for, I think in future we did that, right? Future and forward. So there, the same thing, you can use it here. So this is it. So let me summarize it before you go with the thorough revision now itself. First, we started with the concept of binomial tree for computation of option pricing. Now, binomial tree is one of the tool used for computation of option value based on the concept of present value. That is, the basic idea behind that is you are making a comparison with whether to go with present investment in the spot market, or should you go into the derivative market, taking into consideration the probability or the chance factor of arriving at your estimated destination. That is your strike price, arriving at the strike price. So that is what you go with. And as we said, the binomial tree construction can be single model or multi-model. In case of single model, there will be only one step, where one up and down. That is why we call this model as binomial. Every step is, is assumed to have two nodes, that is one up and down. So that is why this model is called as binomial model. And along with this, there are some assumptions, the basic assumptions which are made by the founders when they go with explaining this binomial model. That is, they said that the general aspect of investor attitude towards risk it's absent, then the other features in the market like transaction cost, or as you say, the commission, the charges that will be adding up to the cost of the asset is almost absent. That's something which they have included in the condition that to make the model a little more simple. And they have also looked into the concept of market going with competitive forces like demand and supply, and less of behavioral aspects being applied in the computation of binomial option value, because that's why we go with the probability factor, looking into the track record. But still, we are not incorporating the sentiments, market sentiments, into this model. But at the same time, we take care of the volatility of the market by incorporating the measure of volatility as standard deviation. Now, looking into this model construction for computation of value, option value, there are basically three steps. Step one, construction of a binomial tree based on the information given to us, which is nothing but we are projecting the price of the underlying asset at different periods. And then we go with computation of value for each of those nodes, option value for each of these nodes. And the third step is coming backward to arrive at the present value of a future earnings, the future earnings which you expect in the form of option. It can be the case of call option, or it can be the case of put option. But the primary discussion point was with respect to European option, where the exit is expected only during the final expiration date. But model becomes a little more complicated where in case of American option, because here you will have lot of end nodes which is based on the available exit point for the investor.